everybody. Today is the very last day of the TD Summer Reading Program for this year. Congratulations, everybody, we made it. Now, since today is our last story time video until the fall, we thought that we could do something extra special for you today. Are you ready to see what we put together for you? Let's go check it out.
Let me hear you sing. Sing it together, louder than ever. Forget everything, just sing like it's what we've been missing. And they're gonna listen, listen. Forget everything, just sing. You think you've gotta hide it. Don't keep it on the shelf. Let your waist start moving. Watch the way I do it, do it. See me do it like nobody else.
If we sing it all together,
if we sing it all as one,
it's not a thing yourself. Everybody's looking. Watch the way we do it, do it.
'Cause we do it like nobody.
About. Unlike most kids, Shaylee loved bedtime. She'd shimmy into her PJs, brush her sparkling smile, and then raid the bookshelf for the perfect bedtime stories. Her dad would squish into the rocker with her, and they'd read until their eyelids refused to stay open. The arrangement worked perfectly. Until her dad got a new job. Oh, look at her poor dad. He's so tired after work. He's asleep on the couch with tons of paperwork. And he's working on the computer and taking calls. Oh man, he's having a hard time. Finally, Shaylee reached her limit. "You're fired," she announced. She put up a job notice first thing the next morning. And her job poster says, "Help wanted, bedtime storyteller, must love books. Apply within. Interviews begin promptly at 6:30 p.m. She began interviews shortly before bedtime. Do you see anybody in this picture that looks like you might recognize them? I see some pigs and some dwarves. The fierce competition scared off the first three applicants. We know those four. That's the three little pigs and the big bad wolf. The next applicant brought along her seven bodyguards, which was fine until Shaylee offered them snacks. "Don't eat that. It's the Wicked Queen in disguise." Uh-oh, Shaylee tried to give Snow White and the dwarves an apple, and they don't like that. Shaylee refused to interview any more applicants that night. Aw, Gingerbread Man looked sad. Before going to bed, she added another line onto her job notice. "Individual applicants only." And that means she wants one person at a time. The next night, the first applicant seemed delightful until he ran away with the book. Shaylee refused to come out from under the bed to interview applicant number two.
"Fee-fi-fo-fum, I hear the yawn of a tired one."
In the morning, Shaylee changed her sign again. She's written now, "Human applicants only." At the next interview, Shaylee's ears pricked right up. The applicant could spin tails that kept her on pins and needles. She was about to offer her the job when the woman zonked out mid-sentence. Do you know who that is? Sleeping Beauty. Now the second girl was particular about where she would sit. "This chair's too hard. This beanbag's too soft. This bed is just right." Now she's changed her sign again. "Must be able to stay awake past 8 p.m. She's having a lot of trouble. Shaylee had low expectations for the next round, but the first applicant had a very impressive resume. Her voice was musical, she could stay up past midnight, and she was obviously human. The two of them had a ball until Shaylee used the sooty fingerprints all over her favorite book. That looks like it must be Cinderella, and she's covered in soot from sleeping near the fireplace. The second applicant hooked her right away. His storytelling gave her goosebumps, as did the yucky gunk in between his teeth. Ew, Captain Hook hasn't been brushing his teeth. Ugh. She's changed her sign again.
And now it says, solid hygiene skills required. That means you have to be clean. That means brushing your teeth and taking your baths and showers. Shaylee despaired of ever finding a replacement for her dad. Until one final job seeker showed up. Hey, he looks kind of like Robin Hood. He looked kind of familiar, and his voice was just right. Best of all, he smelled like strawberries and chocolate chip cookies. So, Shaylee offered him the job on one condition. Peter Pan was actually just her dad in a costume, and her one condition is off limits during bedtime stories. And in this bucket, she's put his phone, his computer, and all of his work stuff. That means he's not allowed to look at those during bedtime. I really liked those stories. And in the back, you can see the resumes of all of the fairy tale people. And that's the end of this story. I hope you guys really enjoyed all of our story times this summer, and I had so much fun making them for you. Enjoy the rest of your summer and keep doing tons of awesome reading. I will see you guys with more videos again in September. Goodbye, everybody.
Sing it together. Louder than ever. Forget everything. Just sing like it's what we've been missing. And they're gonna listen. Listen. Forget everything. Just sing.